السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ملء السماوات والأرض وملء ما شاء ربنا، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today's topic is going to be about الدعاء. And what is important about dua. And as we all know, Shahru Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He put a lot of blessing in it. And one of the most important things that somebody has to think about is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah in the beginning or in between the ayat of As-Siyam. Subhanahu wa ta'ala had told Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that if the servants or if the slaves, my slaves, Allah's slaves, which is all we are, and it's an honor to be a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is close. Allah is close. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. الاستجابة is the response. We have to respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to obey. And by obeying, the dua is مخ العبادة. Like Rasul sallam says in the hadith, إِنَّ الدُّعَاءُ هُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ. Dua that we make is really the true ibadah. Why is it? First of all, you have to answer to Allah. And when you answer to Allah, that means you obeyed Allah. Now, let's see more into the dua itself. Why the dua is so important? In another hadith for Rasulullah sallam, he said that dua is مخ العباد, the mural or the brain or the mural of what is in the bones for us is actually the without it, your body cannot. Same thing with the dua. It is the brain of our deen, ibadah. And ibadah is very important. What is ibadah? Ibadah, there is a lot of ways to make ibadah. There is ibadah with dhikr. There is ibadah with salah. So there is some physical ibadah. There is ritual ibadah. When you think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, think about His creation, all of that is ibadah too. So dua is actually is a proof, because watch this. There is responding to Allah, then there is believing in Allah. And if you got both of those, then you are actually fulfilling al-ibadah. The true ibadah is you admitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is the one who gives you. We cannot get there. Without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot do anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, في سورة غافر, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ دُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. دُعُونِي أستجب. So in here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the ibadah. If you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. And since He talked about the ibadah as a dua, He made al-istijaba, the answering for it, as an equivalent for dua as a ibadah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer you if you make dua. Now, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said something very important about dua. He says, I do not worry about al-istijab, but I worry about making the dua. Because dua is ilham min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put that in you. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making dua all the time. And there is a lot of dua ma'thura, and we will get to it inshallah. We will mention some of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that you could use. There is dua in the morning, there is dua before the salah, there is dua after the salah, there is dua at night, there is dua before you go to bed. الدعاء is actually, it's like sending messages to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I need, ya Allah, I need this. Oh Allah, I need money. Oh Allah, I need a better life. Oh Allah, I need your forgiveness. Oh Allah, I need heaven. Oh Allah, I need, oh Allah, fix my life. This is all is good. Because Allah sallam, actually in his dua, he makes ista'adha out of a lot of things. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر ونعوذ بك من عذاب القبر. Oh Allah, I ask your protection from الكفر and الفقر, to be poor. عذاب القبر, you know, the punishment in the grave. Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني loves it when people ask him with the dua. And the best way to make dua, which is a lot of people might not recognize this, but if you read the Quran, which is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is probably the highest way of asking Allah. You don't even need to make dua. Once you read in the Quran, you're already making dua. And look how much in the Quran, there is a lot of ad'iyah. There is a lot of du'as of some of the prophets, like Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salam. Sayyidina Yunus, and has the story was so beautiful when he escaped and he went to the boat, and then they decided to throw him in to the water and the whale swallowed him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he went in that, just imagine. وَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. It is amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had explained to us that situation. Sayyidina Nuh was in darkness, the darkness of the sea, the darkness of the whale, inside the whale. The angels, they say, the angels was hearing his prayers. And the angels said, oh Allah, we know this voice. We know it. We are familiar with this voice. We are familiar with this tasbih. Who is this? Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salam. Then Allah says, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. And if it wasn't, so a tasbih is basically a part of dua. It is actually making dua when you make tasbih too. Then in his dua, he says, first of all, he says, لا إله إلا أنت. So he admit with الوحدانية لله سبحانه وتعالى. سبحانك, glory to you. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. The third thing, he admit his mistake. He admit that he did something wrong. And that is, these are the three things that any believer need to understand. So when you make dua, you always want to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with, you have to be actually broken. You have to be tatadhallan ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tatadarra ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with sincere dua. When you are in need, it's totally different. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one. Who is the one who will answer? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, for those who need him, unless Allah. Allah is the one and only one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he is a Rabb, he is the Lord, he is the one who provided everything for us. Before we even came to this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had put everything for us, made us the best of his creation for a reason. Then believe me, he did not leave us alone. Allah is always there for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so close to us. If you need anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer back. Then there is a hadith Qudsi that I would like to mention, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that there is four characteristics or four things. One of them for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one, it's between Allah and between Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the third one, it is between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and people or the believers. The very first one, it is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَتَعْبُدُنِي لَا تُشْرِكَ بِي شَيْئًا. Then the second one from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that if you did good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you with good. The third one, it is to, if you make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make al-ijabah. The fourth one, it is between Rasulullah and everybody else, is that whatever you wish for yourself, you wish for everybody else. And in this hadith, that shows you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the dua, Rasulullah mentioned dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the istijab. Then another hadith, Rasulullah mentioned to us that for any Muslim, if he makes the dua and he does not, if he has a dua, is a good dua. Like, you know, he doesn't mean to harm people or make dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer that dua in three ways. First of all, he might answer it in this life. Second of all, he will keep, if he didn't answer in this life, he will keep the reward for the day of judgment. Or he will remove something bad from somebody's life if it was equivalent to that dua. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a great God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is hospitable with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to make that dua. And the dua is, again, remember, the dua is actually al-ibadah. And al-ibadah is, you know, to know God, to ask Allah. You need to know Him, to ask Him. How, if anybody goes to anybody and ask Him for anything, you will not ask unless you know this person you're going to ask has what you're looking for. And وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلِ الْأَعْلَى, and God has the greatest example. By doing the dua and asking Allah, you are already admitting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your Lord. You are admitting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. He is the one who takes care of you. You want anything. You want to remove this hardship. Ask Allah for dua. And this is the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this month the easy month for all of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all us. وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته